Hi everyone, I'm Dan Lourenço, and this is a quick tip for Mac Tuts Plus. Today I'm going to show you what burn folders are. Burn folders are a feature of Mac OS X that allow you to easily burn data to CD or DVD. Creating them is quite easy, but there are some important considerations to take into account when using them. I'll explain later on, but first, how do we create one? Well, like most things in OS X, it's easy. Just click on the File menu in the Finder, and select New Burn Folder. And as we can see, we now have our burn folder on the desktop. So, as you might expect, you can simply drag items to this folder, and the contents of said folder will be burned to your optical disk. Now, the important thing to note is that you are not, I repeat, you are not copying those files from their origin into the burn folder. What you're actually doing is creating an alias, or a pointer, to the original files inside the burn folder. So why does it work this way? Well, this is useful so that you're not duplicating data on your hard drive, and any changes to the original files will be accounted for the next time you burn to disk. So that's great and all, but if you remember, I did say that there were some important considerations to take into account when using burn folders. And rather than try and explain it to you verbally, I'll show you. So let's go and open up our documents folder. And I'm going to grab this PDF and drag it into the burn folder. And hey, look, we have a folder called Things to Burn. I'll drag that into the burn folder as well. And so if we open up the burn folder, you'll see these little arrows on the corner of these documents. And that indicates that it's an alias. And remember, an alias is just a pointer to a file. It's not the actual file itself. So if I go ahead and delete this alias and we go back to our original location, we'll see that, yep, the PDF is still here. But here's the thing. Only the top level of the burn folder is an alias. That means when I double click on a folder inside the burn folder, I'm now inside the original location of the data. I'm no longer working with aliases, and anything I do to files in here I'm doing to the source. Let me demonstrate. Okay, so we have our documents over here. And as we can see, we have our two PDFs inside the Things to Burn folder. And now we're inside the Burn folder. And as soon as I double click Things to Burn, well, notice we don't have those little arrows that indicate an alias. So I want you to keep an eye on this documents folder to the left, okay? I'm going to go ahead and delete this tax return PDF. And like I said, keep your eyes on the tax return PDF on the left. It's gone. I'm sure you can see how this could present a problem if you're not careful. Otherwise, the alias model is really a good idea. That way, you always have the most up-to-date information when you are burning items to your optical drive. Okay, great. So now that we have that important consideration in mind, how do we actually burn everything? Well, it's pretty easy. Let's open up the burn folder, and you'll see this bar at the top that says burn folder, and it's got this shiny button called burn. Well, click it. And you can name your disk, choose your burn speed, and hit burn, and you're ready to rock. So that's pretty much it. My name is Dan Lorenzo, and thanks for watching.